now, last but not least, we have our last speaker of the day, who is Koen Adolfs. It's lead product owner, open banking and enterprise integration technology at ABN AMRO. He will talk with us about embedding finance opportunities for developers in the new era bank. The great story is that Koen was attendees in our 2015 or 2014 conference, then went speaker, and now he's the big boss of APIs of ABN AMRO. So hello, Koen, how are you?
I'm doing good, thank you. And APIs is never something that you do alone, right? So being the big boss, that's definitely not the case. Driving a community, driving a change into the company, that's what I like to achieve. And it's not about being the big boss.
No, of course. When I say big boss is in terms of content, we all love to invite you. So you are our big boss, if that's
thank you.
Like that. You are our big boss. I don't want to put any hierarchy. There you are, our big boss of APIs, right? So your slides are perfect there. They're full screen. The stage is yours for 20 minutes. Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you. Yeah, so after a full day of talking about APIs, and then you come to a bank which is trying our utmost best to drive the API community internally and externally as well. And as Maddie said, I attended previous conferences, also talked at previous conferences, and I always like to do these updates. And what I try to do is to bring a full story of what we are doing at ABN AMRO, so both the internal and the open story. And I often need to start with a slide, also if I talk externally outside of ABN AMRO, to explain APIs. And of course, at the API Days event, I don't need to explain APIs again. But as I try to share the journey that we are on and the conversations that we are having with customers, the conversations that we are having internally, this slide helps me always a lot to explain what an API is and what it does. And just to start off the story, kicking off, looking at what APIs are contributing in other industries, it's also nice to see what we as a bank are now on and where we are at. So, of course, Uber, they are using the Google Maps API and the PayPal API, and they build their applications on top of that. And then they provide an API back to Google Maps, and that's how digital ecosystems are being created. And we try at ABN AMRO to do a similar kind of approach. So while in the 2000s, we started to build internet banking, and in 2011, we created mobile banking as a new digital channel. We also started our API journey. So the story is that we as a bank now have three digital channels, which over time should work together in creating good customer experiences in every channel or digital experience where the customer is at. And it's still a big journey, and that's also what I would like to share in this story. But we have some nice successes and customer use cases that I can explain, where we have built nice API products that third parties are now using. Also customers that are using our other digital channels and are automating their own processes with our APIs. So what I would like to achieve within the bank, and that's still a big hurdle to take, but a good ambition to have as a big company, is of course you already have your own system. So you have your internet and mobile banking systems. You provide customer experiences in those channels, and you try to build good proper architecture in those channels. And we all understand that already building internal APIs, building good landscapes for your own channels is a challenge and a big journey for many industries, many companies to take. ABN AMRO is no different, but the ambitions that we have is if you have good, for instance, transaction banking APIs and you use them in your own channels, then you can also reuse them by partnering up with third parties and with partners to build new customer experiences on top. And what I often hear on conferences is that we talk about our open APIs and our partner APIs, but we don't make those internal journeys and those open API journeys, we don't connect them to each other. And that's explicitly something that we try to do at ABN AMRO, where if you have good internal APIs available, you can also use them to partner up and the other way around. And one good example for that is the case of Travel Essence, where we have a service for foreign exchange trade. Companies, third parties are using our FX services to do currency conversions. And one of our customers is Travel Essence, and this is a travel agency arranging all kind of trips to Australia and New Zealand. And of course, they have to manage many currencies. And over time, we saw that these kind of customers could benefit of our services via an API. And that's also what we now offer to this customer. I have a video in which the company explains what they are doing with our API.
Travel Essence is een reisbedrijf die opmaat maakt de reisregen naar Australië en Zeeland. Die reis die wij maken is uniek. We zijn in 15 jaar geen twee keer dezelfde reis geregeld.
Ja, op het moment dat een klant hier aan tafel zit en hij zegt ja tegen zijn reisvoorstel, dan betekent dat we eigenlijk een verplichting aangaan om vreemde valuta te betalen op termijn. En we weten dus ook wanneer we hoeveel dollars nodig gaan hebben. Dat zijn handmatige transacties, omdat het heel moeilijk te bundelen is, zijn het ook heel veel transacties. En dan ben je ook niet goed schaalbaar. Dat willen we niet. We willen alles wat de computer kan doen, we willen echt wel computer laten doen. We zijn eigenlijk op continue basis in gesprek met ABN AMRO. Uit een van die gesprekken kwam naar voren dat ABN AMRO een nieuw systeem had waarbij we automatisch konden koppelen met dit bankaire systeem. Dat doen die transacties dus automatisch in het schiet in plaats van handmatig. Nou, voor ons werd dat juichend ontvangen, want we zijn innovatief. We houden van vooruitgang, maar we houden ook van verbetering. Elke dag proberen we het weer een stukje beter te maken. Het grootste voordeel zit hem in die tijdsdienst. Vroeger moesten alle transacties handmatig worden ingeklopt door iemand. Dat scheelt iemand op onze finance afdeling ongeveer een dag per week. Een ander voordeel is natuurlijk de timing. We kunnen veel nauwkeuriger valuta inkopen en terugverkopen die we niet nodig hebben. Als je kijkt naar de samenwerking tussen ABN AMRO en Travel Essence, dan verloopt die altijd uitstekend. We hebben dat traject aangepakt, we hebben hier iemand ook erbij gezet die vanuit de ID-kant dat goed heeft begeleid. En zo hebben we eigenlijk met heel veel contact en heel veel proberen en testomgeving hebben we dit systeem vrij snel en goed werkend kunnen krijgen. Het mooiste moment was echt wel dat eigenlijk het proces wat je jarenlang handmatig hebt gedaan, nu op computer gedaan kan worden. En dus iedereen blij, ABN blij, wij blij en onze medewerkers blij, want iedereen doet leuke dingen. Ik heb geen idee waar deze technologie allemaal naartoe gaat, maar ik verwacht eigenlijk wel dat er veel meer gebruik zal worden gemaakt van data, van patronen, artificial intelligence, die bepaalde voorspellingen kan gaan doen. Dan kan je echt op de troep vooruit lopen.
Ik word trots van een project zoals dit, omdat het geeft ons de mogelijkheden om accuraat te zijn per klant. En dus op die manier kunnen wij onze jaarrekening, onze koersverlies worden in centen berekend. En niemand anders doet dat.
So this is a nice case where you see that ABN AMRO investigated which capabilities do we have, but also what are the needs of our customers. And both internally and externally, you see that it's quite a journey to take on together. Everybody needs to change a bit. So it's first about believing, then it's about understanding what is the technology, what is the capability that we should offer, then enable teams to build APIs, to consume APIs, support them in the questions that they have and in the struggles that they will meet along the way. And only if those parts are there and if you have done that properly, you see that both customers but also a bank wants to change. And that's the big journey that we are on as a bank, but also a lot of other companies and you in this session will recognize that it's all about change, and it's not only about technology change, but it's also about mindset and capabilities that we need to gain. The big change, and this is a slide that I presented in previous events as well, is that we need to go from an ecosystem where we think in a centralized way, in an everything is invented inside by one team, owned and closed, etc., to a more ecosystem way of thinking, where it's more about distributed innovation, shared and open, many-to-many connections. And this is not something that is only happening with the outside world again. So it's not only about open APIs, but it's also about how do you organize the cultures internally in your organization as well. And that's also why we at ABN AMRO have two portals. So one is a external facing one to customers, to partners, where we offer our open and partner APIs, and we have commercial ambitions with those APIs. And we have the internal portal where we have a full portfolio available of internal enterprise APIs that teams can use and reuse. And we offer them a makerspace with all the e-learnings and communication material and tools that the teams need to build proper APIs. And that's those tools and those procedures can then be used for both the internal APIs and open APIs. So it's a big connected journey that we are trying to build as an organization. Also in the architecture that we have at ABN AMRO, you see that that connection is there. So we have our own backends where we have provider service applications and external providers. We have an ESB available for complex services. And then you have the combination that regardless where the service is coming from, so from a third party, from our own backend or via the ESB, everything needs to be connected to each other via the internal API gateway and then offered to our own channels. So the ABN AMRO bank channels, AAB channels, to other AA bank applications or to external consumers. And if you go to external consumers, we have that external API gateway in place as well. And that's something, this architecture, but there's also how you use this architecture. Took us quite some time to build, but we are progressing well in this. For you, as an external party, I would like you to invite to go to developer.abnamro.com, because over there, of course, you can see which API products we currently have available, where you can build your applications on, and where you can connect your ecosystems, your customer experiences to the capabilities that ABN AMRO is having. Our API products in that sense offer real-time interactions and data, real-time access, 24/7, 365 days a year, in an efficient, secure manner. And it's giving you the flexibility and the connectivity to build your customer experiences. Of course, we have the PSD2 services available, but we also have the APIs available that are needed for our own corporate customers to build those customer experiences. And in the next slides, I have a couple of nice use cases where we see our customers building on our APIs. Again, APIs is quite a journey, and you can help us to be successful in that journey. Broekhuis is one of the customers that we have, and it's one of the biggest car dealers in the Netherlands. And they are using our business account API to automate their processes. So when a customer is paying for a service, normally the employee didn't have immediate insights in if the customer had paid and if that was all included in their systems, in their CRM, etc. And also on the customer channel side, they had challenges in creating the customer experiences that that they want. And with the business account insight API, they were capable of creating the customer experiences that that they want. We also have a pilot with Packly, and Packly is a startup with platform workers. And those platform workers are going to all kind of companies to get shampoo or to get products for your house, and you can order, and those platform workers deliver them to your house. And normally, these platform workers would be paid at the end of the month. With the product that we've built, they can be paid real time each time that they do a gig. And also this experience is built on our APIs. Then we come to Bux, and Bux is a investment app where we see that both our venture funds is investing in the company as a whole, so in the investment company. And meanwhile, our clearing department is offering a backend $2 to store the money of customers on ABN AMRO systems. And that is working out for both the fintech and for us as ABN AMRO in many ways. And the last example that I would like to share is Tikkie. And Tikkie is a payment request app, which is very popular in the Netherlands. We have about 7 million users in the Netherlands. And basically what Tikkie does for normal retail customers is once you go to a restaurant with friends, you want to split the bill and one person is paying for it. And with Tikkie, he can send a payment request via WhatsApp or any channel that he likes to a person or to a group of people to split that bill. Now, over time, we saw that also corporates would like to use the Tikkie application in similar ways as we offer to our retail customers. But of course, you don't want an employee to create a payment request each time that a customer is doing an interaction in their channels. Things need to be automated. And that's also why we build an API on top of Tikkie. So then we have a Tikkie portal for our business customers, a Tikkie app, but also the Tikkie app, Tikkie API. So all those interactions can be created in an automated way. And DHL was in the Corona period, in the COVID period, one of the first users of that API in to deliver experiences to both their employees and retail customers. And again, I have a video of that.
We set the ticket in of the town by sending it to the ophalen by klanten and presenting it to the afleveren. Het grootste probleem dat ik de day out spread oplost is dat de courier geen handheld device wat hij niet uitwisselt met de klant. Vice versa, om besmettingsgevaar tegen te gaan, om COVID-19. En daarnaast is het ook voor de courier veel makkelijker om de minimale afstand van anderhalve meter te belagen.
Klanten werkt weer in de Google. Het is weer een nieuw betaalmogelijkheid, dus het is ook vernieuwend.
Betalen met een Tikkie, dat gaat eenvoudig. De courier opent op zijn handheld Tikkie, komt vervolgens de dag in wat de klant moet betalen en de courier ontvangt de rest van die betaling.
So, as shared, the API journey is a long one, and a lot of people in this conference will experience the same. It's all about believing, understanding, enabling, supporting, and wanting to change. This is where we are at on our journey, and I'm looking forward to what you build on our APIs and also the future conversations in how we can progress as Europe in creating digital ecosystems as a whole. If there are any questions or you would like to meet up, you can contact me on my email, my Twitter, or my LinkedIn. Looking forward to meet up.
Thank you very much, Kun. We have one question. What have been your biggest learning navigating APIs, you know, from the last 5 years at ABN AMRO?
Yeah, the biggest learning in that sense, it's that it is a endurance journey. So it's not something you shared that my first conference was in 2014, 2015, which is true. And then it was really about gaining the knowledge yourself. But then you need to enable others, giving that knowledge further. You need to build up the capabilities. And then once you think, oh, we have the first API products available, then it's big bang ecosystem change, right? But then you also need to educate your customers and partners in using those APIs, because they are unacquainted. The banks are offering these capabilities, and they also have teams with product owners and their own backlogs and et cetera. So everything is about endurance. But as long as you see the progress going on, that motivates. And also these kind of events really helps to connect. And that's a shared struggle that we are on. But it's a nice journey. So endurance is definitely one that I learned over time.
We have a question about how is adoption speed? How many corporate customers per month are you implementing, if you are allowed to share these numbers?
I cannot share those numbers also because I don't have them top of mind. You see that the PSD2 APIs, of course, on the regulation part, the usage is growing steadily. What I personally see is that still a lot of customers, so the end users, need to be, how do you say it? Not convinced, but need to see the right propositions to use those API to use those third-party applications, and therefore also the API. So it's also not a big bang change, but a steady growth, and a similar kind of feeling I have with the commercial APIs, where you see once a customer has found a nice use case, then it's also easier to convince other customers, and then you will ramp up. But it's also that part, it's an endurance and a steady growth that we see.
We have a question about when the shift happens, moving from regulation to business, was it imposed by a use case from a customer or user?
So what was interesting is that at the one hand, the regulation of PSD2 was in place, and we as a company needed to build the capabilities to build open APIs so we can share our PSD2 data. But I wanted to be earlier with the developer portal and test if our support processes were in play and test if the developer portal was working properly. And I wanted to learn what developers were to have as a customer. So I was also searching for which ambitions does the bank already have where I can connect to. And Tiki was already an application with quite some users. And they like to see that attract that business user as well. And for that domain, there was already a API question going on. So we were first with commercial versions of our APIs, and then we did the PSD2 route. And that's that helped us a lot to find those use cases in the organization where we already could progress.
And we have a last question from Fabor here. What's the most common argument against APIs you hear, and how do you handle it?
The internal of the open API. So for the open APIs, it's the mindset one. So why opening up an API? How would it contribute to both the bank and the customer experience? And it's much more helping people to think in a certain way about digital ecosystems. Internally, the challenge is much more, the bank has a lot of ambitions and a lot of priorities. And of course, APIs help you to build future-proof technologies and future-proof architecture. It also takes a bit time to build it properly. And in the end, you will benefit, but you need to do it now. And making the right balance calls in that between all the ambitions that we have on clouds, on AI, on the channels, on the customer experience, on the regulation, and balance that with implementing future-proof architecture, that's the balancing act.
Okay, last question, because this one is really good. If you'd speak again in API Days in 2024, what is the change you would like to see at ABN AMRO and the banking industry with regards to APIs?
So what I currently try to implement is proper API portfolio management. And again, I think that that's a journey. And I hope that that will be a successful initiative, but I'm not sure. Thing that I'm developing closely connected to the internal API portal. And I haven't seen that around in other internal portals or in other companies yet. So if people have ideas in how to do proper portfolio management in a decentralized way related to all the initiatives that you run as a company, then I would like to be inspired.
Yeah, thank you very much, Kun. And again, let's remind what you say, an API program or whatever it is a group effort, even if group is made of individuals, that can be great. It's always a group effort. So thank you for reminding that. It does not remove the how individual can be really good at some time. Thank you, Kun.